still thinking. Okay. Wow. So in this video, I'll briefly review a tool, an AI artificial intelligence tool that is supposed to help us read complex research papers. How cool does that sound? I hope that it delivers. I kind of started on this tool. I was sent it. It's not a paid promotion. I was sent this tool to explore it, but I wasn't paid for anything I say. So it will be a very honest review. I'm curious. I only started to play around with it a little bit, but I didn't continue. I decided I want to do it with you guys. So let's have a look at this tool and what it has to offer. Okay, so that's what it's called. It's called Sitespace. As they say, they will help us decode any research paper, which again, as I said, sounds exciting. Hopefully they can deliver. We can upload a PDF. I'll let you decide. I'll let you explore it further. Just so you know, as I said, I'm a complete beginner when it comes to this platform. It's not paid, so I'm not sure what the catch is. Maybe eventually they'll make it paid, but for now it's not paid. You can explore it any minute as well. You can upload a PDF or go to my library, which I already uploaded some PDFs because I couldn't believe that they will indeed help me decode some of these documents. So I'm just going to go straight to my library. There are two completely different research papers. I did want to experiment a little bit. There is one about psychedelics and their use and the experiences they cause. And another one is about status loss, so it's kind of like more educational psychology. Let's just go to this one first. So we're opening a PDF. You can upload your own. As I said, you can upload anything you want. And here we are. We're reading our PDF with this tool. Now, what do we have here? I think this is what I already asked the tool to translate before. So let's just keep scrolling. It says highlight the text to explain it. Let's find something really difficult. Let's see what it does and how it does it. So let's find a nice and complex academic boring sentence. Okay, I think I like this one. Originally framed by Weber to capture the dynamics of esteem and privilege that accrue to social groups with a shared lifestyle, status has been more broadly construed. This one is complex for me to read aloud, that's for sure. Let's see what it does. Okay, highlight the text, explain it. Okay, now it says explain the text. Let's explain the text. I clicked on it. Read more. How do we do here? Okay, here is the explanation. See, that's what I'm quite impressed by, I must say. It doesn't feel like Google Translate tools or these other so-called AI tools that are just far from perfect and you can straight away tell something is not right. If you look at this, it does sound like nice sentences, nice explanations. So let's see, highlighted text is discussing the concept of status, which is a term used in sociology and social psychology to refer to the relative rankings of individuals or groups in terms of prestige, respect, and influence. Let me see if it's, was this information in that sentence? It wasn't. That's the thing, it wasn't. So this is what I like already. I don't know where it gets this information from. Does it get it from the same paper? Does it get it from online, from all obviously huge databases and Wikipedia and all other tools? I'm not sure, but it's already telling us what status is. So that's pretty useful, I think. Now it's basically talking about the concept and when it was framed. So that's okay. Let's see what else it does. Let's see if it's just a repetition or is it something new that we can actually understand and learn from it. This is a similar sentence. It has been further developed by them. These scholars articulated the foundational role of status. I guess it's okay. It's okay. It's still, I would say, if I couldn't understand this sentence, there would still be some parts of it that I don't understand. But having said this, there is some more explanation. You can see that as opposed to this short sentence, it's kind of developing things further and explaining them. So, okay, let's keep reading, and I'll just find a sentence that I feel that can be quite difficult to understand. Okay, I found it. Achieve status can modify status valuation. What does this mean? Explain text. So I'm a student, I just came to the UK, and I don't understand what they mean. So that's, I don't actually, like I said, I can as well just be a British student. Doesn't matter, because these texts, they are just so hard to understand. Look at this, this is impressive. This is a short sentence, short but confusing and complex, in my opinion, sentence. And look what it does. Achieve status is a form of status that is earned through individual effort and competition. It is different from other forms of status, such as race, blah, 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 blah. Achieve status can modify status valuation. That's our sentence. Which is the way in which people are perceived and valued in society. This is something new. So this helps me understand the sentence, right? Examples of achieved status. So it's basically what it's doing is not just explaining this one sentence. I think it's giving me the whole context, and it's probably drawing from some online resources, I believe, to basically break this thing, this concept, this sentence down into pieces. It may not speed up the process, of course. If one sentence has been broken down into four or five, you can see a whole long paragraph. However, this is not the goal. The goal is for me to understand. So if I'm struggling to understand this sentence, which is probably important, it's a topic sentence, the first sentence in the paragraph, but it's difficult to understand. And look at all these things that it's giving me. It's talking about characteristics, it's talking about definitions. This is pretty impressive. Let's just give it another go. I'll switch to my library, and I'll switch to the paper about psychedelics, just to change the topic a little bit. I believe it can be more difficult to understand, more technical, more scientific. Here are some attempts, something that I already chose. So again, I'm scrolling down, trying to find something that I completely struggle to understand. Here we are. I love it. I love this one. I don't think I even should try to read it, but it has a whole bunch of things I don't understand. That's what I know. Some substances, I guess, receptors, affinity at five, whatever receptors, lots of stuff. I literally, there is no way I can understand this. Let's explain this. I don't believe it will explain it in the way that I would understand it, because let's be honest, you probably still have to be, you know, student of medicine or whatever this field is, to have some background. So fair enough, it's not supposed to explain it to a child or anything. So, and I'm a child when it comes to this field. So I like that it's breaking things down. It's creating these whole sentences, such as the highlighted text is discussing, just gives you this feeling that is, in fact, is guiding you through this difficult content. So it's discussing the potential differences between psychedelic drugs such as psilocybin, LSD, and DMT. Okay, so that's quite smart. It's impressive, because it's summarizing the whole idea first, what's happening in these highlighted sentences. And then it's going into detail of these things I couldn't understand. So these different receptors, and it's saying what they are. It's a receptor in the brain that's activated by these psychedelic drugs. So, and then as it goes on to continue the rest of the sentence, I must say I'm really impressed. I am really impressed by this. I can only imagine how helpful this could have been when I was a student and I was reading about things like, let's take worldviews and positivisms and all this stuff. Imagine that. This looks really helpful. It has lots of other options that I haven't even started to explore. There is something that says explain math and table. This would be for some formulas, as it says. I don't think there is anything like that. So definitely worth exploring this option if you have such paper. There are also other things. There are other things such as describe practical implications of this paper. And there you have different suggestions. You can ask questions. Let's have a look. Let's have a quick look. Explain abstract in one line. What has this paper contributed? Okay, let's go for this one. I believe this will be drawn from the implications section. So the abstract will be drawn from abstract, the implications from the implications. I don't think it will come up with something completely new and groundbreaking, but it's not the point, is it? It will still summarize, I believe, the key points. So you may just open a paper and ask it to tell you straight away about the implications. So it has contributed to the understanding of how psychedelic drug experiences can occasion changes in perspectives on death and dying. This is interesting. It's summarizing things, and I believe that's what it is. In this case, it's summarizing things, which at the same time is a contribution, but it's nevertheless it's very useful. Let me just ask one final question. This one is going to be a tricky one, so we're going to probably confuse our AI. What methods were used in this research? Because it's a qualitative researcher here asking, so I want to know about the methods. What methods were used in this research? It's thinking. Still thinking. Okay. Wow. This is good. I like it. I like this tool. It's summarizing the methods, so again, it's probably digging from the whole paper. Summarizing the methods, explaining samples. Now I'm impressed. Should I share this knowledge? Is it gonna put me out of my job? Do you think? Anyway, to summarize, this still looks pretty good. As I said, it's not an advert. I haven't been paid. I do think it's a very useful tool potentially, so I do encourage you to test it, try it, comment under the video. What are your experiences? Try to find a limitation of this tool. Let's see what it can really do. I'm really interested about this and your opinions. So let's test the hell out of it from all different perspectives, all different students, all different fields, and let's see what it is. This is exciting. I want to know more about this tool. I shared some knowledge with you now in this video, and now I encourage you to do the same and keep exploring it. And let's see what it can do, because who knows, maybe, just maybe, the future is here.